Transphobia's got to go! Hey, hey! Ho, ho! Transphobia's got to go!
Thank you for coming this evening. We're here today, tonight, on another Transgender Day of Remembrance due to the violent actions against transgender women in our nation and in the world. Our remembrance is for the fallen. The transgender women we remember tonight are by no means the only ones. Law enforcement's lack of education on transgender issues, and in my opinion, their pervasive disdain for us as our real and true gender, caused many, many murder victims to be miscategorized. When I was called by the Fox station by reporter Eric Rosales to see footage of Casey Hagler's murder before it hit the news, he told me, he says the police told him that this was a man stabbed on Blackstone Boulevard and possibly a prostitute. I looked at the feeds from the different cameras and I said, Eric, this is a transgender woman. And notice, she's not wearing any clothes at the time. She's walking work down. She's not a prostitute. Her clothing was very extensive and put together, and it was expensive. So the number of us killed at 22 is in no way reflective of all the women that have been murdered this year. Most have been murdered and called men, even though they're women. And you need to know that the 22 is nowhere near the number of transgender women that have been killed. It is much higher. It's a travesty.
We have an inept police force.
These are those we know of. Poppy Edwards, Lamia Beard, Ty Underwood, Yasmin Bash Payne, Taja Gabrielle DeJesus, Kenny Proud, B. Golick, Christina Grant, Infinity, Keisha Fly, Maya Shawatza Hall, Levin Kiki Chanel, Mercedes Williamson, Jasmine Collins, Ashton O'Hara, India Clark, Casey Haggard, Shane Schuler, Amber Monroe, Candace Capri, Elisha Walker, Tamara Dominguez, Keisha Jenkins, and Stella Siona, who was killed by her boyfriend because she embarrassed him in front of her friends, in front of his friends. Infinitely valuable human beings are lost to hateful and evil, heartless transgender men. Let's put their violence against transgender women in this country in perspective. Non-trans women make up over 50% of the United States. Now, if you take 310 million Americans, you divide it. That's 155 million women and girls in the United States. We're four times more likely as transgender women to be murdered. So that means even with all those targets, 0.6% of us United States citizens are four times more likely to be murdered. This is terrible. We transgender women are murdered violently, even though our population is so small. A transgender woman has a 1 in 12 chance of being violently murdered, and if a transgender woman of color, 1 in 6 will be violently murdered. How can this be happening in America? How can this happen in America? We have to be careful who we date, and we have to disclose, or we die. We have to be careful where we knock, or we die. We have to be careful with groups of men, or we die. We have to be aware of it growing dark, or we die. We have to be understanding that no one will help us if we call for help, or we die. We have to somehow know that we're under surveillance by the men who are targeting us, or we die. I've personally been sexually assaulted by a law enforcement official. I couldn't even report it because you wouldn't believe me. I'm a transgender woman. Who would believe me? I've had a man punch me after leaving a transgender event as this trans. And he tried to run me off the road, and he tried to force me to crash my car. And then when I tried to hide in the gas station, he pulled in front of me and tried to block me off. I called the Fresno Police Department. I reported it. I never received a follow-up call. When I reported it to the FBI, they were very interested and said the description matched the murderer of Casey Hagler. The Fresno PD has never called me back. I've had numerous death threats. I've been told by a total stranger that I better watch my back. These things that have happened to me are not isolated to me. This happens to many, many transgender women. This is not an abnormal story. Just look at the comments under any news story about Caitlyn Jenner or Laverne Cox and read what the comments say. The comments are vile. They promote violence. They advocate mayhem. They convey horrible X-rated messages about anatomical parts. They attribute false blame, and they push forward condemnation from false teachings about religion, especially in the Bible, where the Bible has nothing to say about it at all. So many commenters react to transgender people with furious rage and unsuppressed hatred. They reflect the common beliefs of a vast majority of citizens in America. They show the long way that we have to go to change things in this country. We are hated. We're seen as deceivers, liars, phonies, as men posing as women. The science that spells out in great detail our birth difference construction in the womb is unknown by the vast majority of Americans. Even when the science is shared, many people will say, science is not really always right, and science doesn't matter. Or they give you the Bible trumps science. So the culture remains disdaining and hostile against transgender women. And many of us are violently attacked because of this. Many of us are looked at as subhuman. Just like Hitler made the Jews seem subhuman so they could be attacked, we're created as subhuman so we can attack. This must stop. This must stop. This must stop. So what do? We speak out. We live our lives with strength and courage. We make no excuses for being true, real, correct, and authentic. We help each other. We stand together. We educate. We work to transform our culture so our sisters may live. By being true, honorable, tough, resilient, and courageous, we will ultimately change the pervasive disdaining culture and will see the sun finally rise on the day where we can be treated with the kind of dignity and respect that we deserve like any other human beings. We'll be able to go through our lives then and finally be free of fear of being murdered. That's the dream. That's the goal. That's what will happen. I, for one, will continue to fight on front lines to make sure it happens. If you're a disdainer or a hater, I want you to listen to me. To shut us up, you will have to kill us. And that won't be easy any longer because we're standing together.
Yeah.
Thank you very much.
Yeah.